Hello, everybody. This is Scott Bradley coming to you from www.scottbradley.name. And in this video, this is part 3 of 4 of the Today in Year Notebook Overview. If this is the first time that you're seeing a video from me, I highly recommend that you press the Evernote Scott link under the left-hand side of this video and go to part 1 and start there before you watch this video. Watch part 1, part 2, and part 3. If you have already watched part 1 and part 2, this is going to be great. I'm going to go over the next 4 notes in the Today in Your Notebook, which, just a quick overview, the Today in Your Notebook is the dashboard for your life to help you keep everything straight, help you sleep with peace of mind, and help you be more effective with your time as you go throughout your daily life, getting things done, contributing to the world, and adding tons of value to everybody that you come in contact with. So, I'm going to jump right into it. If you know from the previous videos, I'm just going to go over the notes we've gone over, and then I'm going to jump into the next 4. In the previous videos, we went over daily execution, waiting on future opportunities, daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, holding tank, yearly holidays and dates was the start of video 2, current contractual obligations, budget, and addresses to change. So, the next 4 notes in this video are to do with time, cool free tools, products to consider, and products I want. So basically, since this is part 3, I'm going to go over these next 4 in detail, and it's going to be a quick, short and sweet video, and this is going to be great. So what I've done in my Today in Year Notebook with this to do with time note is, I'm sure that you and I both can relate to certain times in our life where we just kind of get to a point where we're like, I am just so bored and I don't know what to do with my time right now. If that happens to you, typically it happens to me after I do a hardcore work session for 4 to 5 hours or an hour and a half, or depending on the day and the time and what I'm focused on. I get to the end of it and I'm like, ugh, I don't want to work anymore, but I want to figure out something else to do with my time to get my mind off of work. So basically what I've done with this note, and again, this is just a template you can use or you can add this, you don't have to have this note, but in mine, I've kind of created it into 4 sections. Actions that make me grow, entertainment, actions that make me enjoy life, and other. So kind of briefly going over these 4 categories, actions that make me grow. This would be reading a book, watching TED Talks, watching other valuable YouTube videos that add value to my life from personal growth people, or listening to books on audio about, you know, getting better or being more effective in what I'm doing. That kind of is the actions that make me grow. Next thing is entertainment. So going to the movies, watching a movie, playing a game, going somewhere to enjoy with friends and family. That would kind of fall under the entertainment one. Actions that make me enjoy life. It's kind of similar to the entertainment one, but maybe this would be taking a walk, going and working out. It really depends on how you want to categorize the difference between your entertainment and actions that make me enjoy life. Maybe this could be going to the playground and watching kids play. I don't know. Whatever floats your boat. And everything else that falls into this, you know, to do with my time, other. Maybe it could be listening to the radio. Maybe it could be drawing. Maybe it could be coloring. Whatever, you know, things that drop into these categories is kind of one thing you could do. And again, since this is really the dashboard for your life, in my opinion, it really gives you the idea like, oh, I haven't done that in a while. I want to do that now. Or, oh, that's interesting. I remember how much I enjoyed doing XYZ activity. And this kind of is, again, that constant reminder that you can just click it up. There it is. What am I going to do? Boom. Next note, cool free tools. Again, if you work on the internet or if you are in a company that forces you to work on the internet, obviously, this may be very helpful for you. In a sense, cool free tools, the definition here is the little things you use online that make your life or work easier. And typically what I do with this note is I put the actual item of what it is. So I explain, let's just again use one of these Google Trends. Okay, I'd put Google Trends and I'd put the link to Google Trends there. And I'd probably make it hyperlinked. So I'd put, you know, http://www. So I can just come to this note, click it, and I get there if I don't want to remember the URLs. So I basically just drop every little link here, and there, as you could imagine, mine, it's probably a long, long list of links. So this would be like embed code generators, free stock image websites, Google Trends, Google Analytics, Google Insights, you know, all those links to, you know, maybe it could be Compete, Alexa, that you just want to go to and have those referenced. Again, you know, I like to use this note, and it kind of clears my mind from the clutter of, oh my God, I got to remember this tool, and I got to remember that tool, and I got to remember it here and there, and blah, 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 blah. You don't have to worry about that, because you always know that you have this note to always come back to and say, oh, what was that tool that did that generator code thing? Oh, that's right. It's in my cool free tools note in that notebook. That's how I use this. Next thing is products to consider. Kind of this note in the Today in Your Notebook kind of accounts for those times where either you're online and you're maybe in your Twitter stream, or you're in your Facebook account, or you're talking to a friend on the phone, and they basically say, oh, you got to check out this new product, or, oh, you know, check out this new tool that does XYZ, or check out this new service or this product or whatever it is. At the end of the day, this note helps you keep track of all of those incoming always things that you may want to buy, but you don't want to buy right now. And this really helps you, again, get the clutter out of your mind, drop it into your dashboard for your life, and know that in the future when you reference it, I mean, and maybe you could have a thing where in your daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, maybe at the end of every quarter, you come into this note and actually say, okay, what were the products I'm considering, and is it time for me to purchase them? You know, it seems that that would be the best way to use this, and that's kind of how I use it. So I like kind of looking and say, oh, I remember that I worked that product down, or oh, I wonder if that company's still in business, or oh, you know, it's kind of a nice dropping point for you and a nice context for you to keep this straight. Now, finally, this is the products that I want. Now, you know, initially when I created my Today in Year notebook, I kept a list of the products I want in here, but I basically created the Daily Fill notebook, which if you haven't watched that video, highly recommend it. I'm trying to think. I believe that the video that you need to watch, let me just go and show you. If you don't know what the Daily Fill notebook is, that video is going to be, again, how to use Evernote to achieve your goals. Come in, click the home button, and click this, how to use Evernote to achieve your goals. And that will explain what the Daily Fill notebook is, but at the end of the day, I'm just gonna show you the one note that is important about this. So in your, as you saw in here, times, products I want. So this should be in your Daily Fill notebook on your vision board. So basically, you go to your Daily Fill, you click your vision board, and your vision board is basically the culmination of the different products that you want. As you can see here, the Nutribullet is here. I love this product. I use it pretty much every day. And so basically you can put all the products that you want, whether it's a car, whether it's a workout system, whether it's a, you know, whatever it is you're going after, you can keep them all managed here. And if you watch that How to Achieve Your Goals video, it will allow you to kind of understand more about what this notebook is and how it kind of integrates in your life. So that is the third video of this 4-part video series, and in the next video I'm going to cover the next 4 notes, and it's going to basically wrap up this 4-part video series. So I really hope that you have enjoyed this video. I've gotten some more value out of it. Again, if you haven't already done so, be sure to go and subscribe, scottbradley.name/evernotetips. Again, every time when you subscribe and you confirm your subscription, every new video that I create for you is going to, you know, you're going to be notified via email every time I publish a new video to this channel. So it's highly recommend that you do it. And again, I'm going to keep all your information private. I'm only going to be the one that sees it. So you're definitely safe and secure when it comes to that stuff. So anyway, I hope you have a great rest of your day, a wonderful rest of your week. And I hope that you're looking forward to the next video where I'm covering the last 4 notes in this Today in Your Notebook. All right, have a good one. Bye for now.